about here.
Is the preferred place for you to be. You don't have a basement. Let's face it, many don't. Get to the lowest floor possible, interior room or closet. The idea is to put as many walls from where you are and the outside to the possible tornado. So you've got one layer of protection, two layers, three layers, four, however many walls you can get between where you are and that possible tornado. That's the key. If you're in a mobile home, get out of there. Find shelter immediately anywhere but a mobile home. If you have to get to a ditch or a ravine, get low and cover your head. No matter where you are, protect your head. If you have an old batting helmet around, a hard hat, a football helmet, how about a bike helmet? Put it on. Put it on now. Doesn't matter how ridiculous it may look, all right? Just for the reason that most fatalities, most injuries from tornadoes occur from debris flying around, hitting people in the head. Let's go back to a cam that we have on in Lexington, Georgetown and Citation, I believe. That storm has not hit the Lexington area right now, but we're looking toward the Scott County area. We have a crew up around the Kentucky Horse Park. They were seeking shelter just a little bit ago as that storm was racing in from the west. So we're going to continue to watch these sky cams, and that sky cam is bouncing around with those gusty winds. Let's go back to our Defender radar network, and I know our crew up in Kentucky Horse Park or the north side of Lexington, I think I see a shot from them, right? All right, let's take this shot, by the way, out of northern Fayette County, and we're up around Ironworks Pike, I believe, right, guys? That's where we're looking from, Ironworks Pike, and we're looking toward that storm that is to the north. And watch this now, that shelf cloud is right on top of our crew. Now our crew, they're inside. So they're in their car now, and watch the winds. There's that shelf cloud right on top of them. And as that makes its way through, the rain is gonna start to really increase, the lightning is gonna increase, and the winds are gonna gust up in a major, major way. So this is a live cam, north side of Lexington, roughly maybe 5 miles as the crow flies from where the tornado warning is out into Scott and Harrison counties. And we've got warnings out for just about the entire length of this line. But that is our crew on the north side of town, Ironworks Pike exit, just off Interstate 75. And they're watching that storm rumbling its way on through. This has a history of producing winds upwards of 60 and 70 miles an hour. And believe it or not, where our crew is right now, the worst of this storm is just off to their north.
They're avoiding it.
Yeah, the storm's really going out of its way right now to avoid hitting our crew on the north side of town. And it unfortunately is targeting Scott County and into parts of Harrison County. So you see, even on the weak side of this storm, how the winds are now beginning to whip up there, and they're getting in on the lightning strikes. But that tornado warning is about 5 miles north of where our crew is right now. And I'm looking at radar. Sirens are going off in Georgetown, as you would expect with that tornado warning that is out for until 7:15 for a part of Scott County into Harrison County.
And they have had a 57-mile-per-hour gust so far, 57.
57 so far.
In Georgetown.
In Georgetown.
Yeah.
A confirmed 57-mile-per-hour gust so far into Georgetown. But on your Defender radar network, we're looking at this, and we've got basically a bow echo shape here. And what I want, Jim, pull up the winds within this, pull up the velocities, because we're going to look on the top of that is where you can get a spin up of a weak tornado, and that's why we have that tornado warning that is in effect. I mean, the winds that are coming through here anyway, with or without a tornado, maybe 70 miles an hour plus in some areas. But I'm looking at this between the Sadieville area and not too far away from the Toyota plant. A lot of this rotation is just to the north of Georgetown. It is just to the north of the Toyota plant, north of Scott County High School. But folks in Sadieville, get to your storm shelter immediately. This does not include Cynthiana for that tornado warning. But Jim, let's go in right in this area here where we're getting on the northern side of this bow. And it is that kind of pinhead where you can sometimes get in on rotation, and we'll put that back on there. But let's give some folks right on Interstate 75 over toward the Muddy Ford area. Boydtown, Turkey Foot is where we're getting in on the greens and the reds that are up against one another, and it's on the top of that bow where if you are to get a little tornado, you can get that to spin up on the top of one of those backward C's that we were showing you 15 minutes ago, tracking those 70-mile-an-hour winds. Here's the Toyota plant, Corporate Boulevard. There's 62, Boydtown along 922 toward Muddy Ford, Turkey Foot. Hey, we got to be in our storm shelters right now. Worst of that, though, Georgetown is off to our north in terms of the rotation. We'll broaden this out a little bit, and we will let's put our storm tracks on that, Jim, and see exactly what Defender is tracking with that and showing where it is going. So you've got that tornado warning that is out that includes Sadieville. Defender is tracking that rotation that continues to work its way across Interstate 75. And if this can hold together, Cynthiana, that will be a problem for you coming up in about 20 minutes or so. The tornado warning does not include Cynthiana. It does include Sadieville and most of the northern half of Scott County and just a small part of Harrison County as of now. It's a short fused tornado warning simply because you want to see what actually happens with this first. Are we just seeing the rotation within this? Is it producing a tornado? Let's find out. Right now, we've had no confirmation. Let's go back to our Kentucky Horse Park cam, or the Ironworks Pike, just down the road from the Kentucky Horse Park, actually. And they're on the weak side of this storm. Worst of that is about 5, 6, 7 miles to the north. Hail reports now coming out of Georgetown that we're getting. I don't see any hail with that part of the storm into northern Fayette County, but you will see just a ton of lightning opening up, and that's going to continue to be the case. And for our crew there, they here momentarily will likely be rolling to the north towards Scott County to see what kind of damage, if any, we can find. So we're going to check back with them coming up here momentarily, but that's on the north side of town now where you're getting that big gust of wind. Look at the lightning. One way to pick out where the strongest storms are, obviously, is to look at the lightning. Look at how you've got all the cluster of lightning here in northern Kentucky and right on top of the Danville area. Hey, Mercer County down into Boyle County, don't want you folks to let your guard down. Don't want you to think we're forgetting about you. Severe thunderstorm warnings are out. You may get winds greater than 60 miles an hour with those storms. Severe thunderstorm warnings are also out for Casey County, down into Russell County and Adair County. And next up on that list potentially would be Lincoln County, the Waynesburg area, Liberty, Casey County, and then points east from there. Richmond, Berea, Mount Vernon, Somerset, London, Corbin, McCreary County, the Whitley City area, Williamsburg, all of these storms will be zipping through there over the next hour and change. But these are severe thunderstorm warnings that continue to be in effect for parts of South Central Kentucky. Let's go back into the bluegrass area now, and you can see those hot spots. Look at the big lightning strikes here, big lightning strikes there. So you've got to watch those hot spots where you can, at least along that line, get those storms to intensify enough to start to rotate and spin up a little weak tornado. So our tornado warning continues in effect for Scott County and a small part of Harrison County just for a few more minutes until 7:15. Jim, any reports coming out of this particular part of the storm, which obviously is the greatest cause for concern right now?
Other than the actual confirmation of the 57-mile-per-hour wind gust, and that was actually in Georgetown, not yet, and it looks like they're reissuing all the way out, though, Chris.
Right now, see that new tornado warning, but that includes Cynthiana into Harrison County now.
So they are confident, and as we were seeing the rotation setting up there, right on the nose of that thunderstorm, it is there. But yeah. I have not seen any pictures or any proof of anybody seeing it on the ground, at least at this point. Now you're getting into a very heavy rain situation as well, so it might be hard to see from a distance.
And this includes a small part of Bourbon County now with that new tornado warning that is out for the far northern parts of Bourbon County, and that includes Cynthiana and Harrison County. That will go until 7:30. So for that storm that is just about done, at least the leading edge of that potential circulation, just about done with Scott County in about 5 more minutes, that'll be out of Scott County and heading across the border into Harrison County and may clip a northern part of Bourbon County. Being told that the Toyota workers there at the Toyota plant just north of Georgetown have taken shelter. Tornado sirens obviously sounding there. In about 5-10 minutes or so, those folks can likely come out of their shelters because the worst of that storm will be bypassing them to the east and the northeast. But indeed, we're seeing a tremendous amount of rotation with that cell just to the south of Sadieville heading into Harrison County. And that is right on the nose of that, or the top of that circulation that we were seeing, Jim, with that bow echo, and that is taking aim toward the northeast. What are you seeing on social media right now?
At this point, again, no damage pictures. It's now, the folks are saying now they're getting in the hail there in Scott County, and I've seen some of the cloud pictures. Nothing that confirms that there's a tornado on the ground or even a funnel spotted. So it's more about just the sheer fact that the strong wind has arrived in those areas and is now driving through, which is part of that nose, because on that nose we're pushing maybe 70 mile per hour wind gusts either anyway, and that is going to cover a larger area period. We've got confirmed 60 mile per hour wind gusts there into Georgetown, and it continues. The stronger part is just north of that area, and that's what continues to kind of angle itself more toward Harrison County as we move forward. So you see there the severe thunderstorm warning that still includes the folks here in Lexington as well up until 7:30. That's a new section of that warning, too, extension of what we had.
And what will happen, Jim, is that basically along the entire length of that line, we're going to see these severe thunderstorm warnings likely following each line. Nicholasville, you're going to be next on the list. Richmond, Berea, Lancaster, we're going to walk it down toward the south. And I believe I see a new tornado warning that is now coming in for Lincoln County and northern part of Casey County. So newly issued tornado warning that is out for a couple of counties into northern parts of the region. That'll go until 7:30. That includes Boyle County, and that includes Lincoln and Casey County. 7:30 with that tornado warning. Let's put the velocities up there and see what we've got with this particular part of the storm. So it's south of the gravel switch area, does not include Danville, but it is for right here where you've got that circulation, that rotation that is showing up on the northern part of Casey County. So very close to the Casey and Boyle County line. And if Houstonville, you need to be in that storm shelter immediately. That extends a little farther to the north. But you look at this circulation center that is right on top of the Ellisburg area, along 78, 243, Butchertown, the Forkland area, over toward Milledgeville and Houstonville, 127. Get in the storm shelter immediately here into parts of Lincoln County, into the Boyle County area, and northern parts of Casey County, too, with that tornado warning that is out into parts of this particular area right now. So seek immediate shelter if you're watching us into the southern half of Boyle County, western parts of Lincoln County, and northern sections of Casey County. Possible tornado is rolling across this area. It's radar indicated, but we're looking at that. And Jim, there is a nice circulation with that just to the north of the Jacktown area here. And again, that is heading over toward Ellisburg along 78. Folks near Butchertown, you got to watch it. And now, look at the new scan that just popped in. All right, now let's increase the level of concern here in the northern parts of the Casey County area, because you've got a tighter rotation that is showing up and that is ready to cross over into southern parts of Bourbon County, or southern parts of Boyle County. Southern parts of Boyle County need to be in that storm shelter immediately. Winds going away from the radar, winds going toward the radar. So you've got that circulation center. The brighter the green, stronger those winds. Brighter the red, stronger those winds. And you're seeing some pretty good couplet that is showing up right now. So Jim, I want to bounce this out a little bit. Let's put a storm track on that. Let's see what Defender is tracking with that part of our tornado warning. This does not include the Danville area. It does not include downtown Stanford, does not include Liberty into Casey County, but it gets right into the Houstonville area, and it is tracking this as a mesocyclone. And basically it's saying, I've got rotation here, and eventually we're going to try to work part of this toward Danville, toward Stanford, and Lancaster. And within the cone for the path of this possible tornado, now it switches over to where it is tracking a TVS, tornado vortex signature, which is what we're seeing here. So that's why when I saw those winds change on that sweep that came in, I said we got to heighten up the talk about this, because this is now tracking this as a possible tornado heading toward, eventually this cone will fan out a little bit, so the exact track on a possible tornado will be somewhere in between, but the cone fans out, cone of uncertainty a little bit. Junction City, Danville, and over the next little bit. But Boyle County, southern parts of Boyle County, western parts of the areas of Lincoln County, and then northern parts of Casey County. Storm shelters now, basement now, lowest floor of your home or office now, because this is a good signature that is showing up with this particular part of the storm that will take it off to the north and northeast. So get into that safe shelter, the basement, interior room, lowest floor possible. Get out of a mobile home if you can. Above all else, you've heard me talk about this numerous times, protect your head. I will keep saying this, put on a bike helmet, put on a helmet, a hard hat, anything, old football helmet. Put it on. I don't care if you look silly or not. It could potentially save your life. Protect your head above all else. That's the key in all this. Most fatalities occur from tornadoes, from gusty winds, because of debris flying around hitting people in the head. So if we protect our head, you know what? You got a really good chance of being A-OK in any type of a setup. But there we go with the overall view. Tornado warning into parts of Lincoln County, small part of Casey County, small part of Boyle County. Also, tornado warning is out for northern parts of Bourbon County and most of Harrison County. That includes the Cynthiana area. Jim, let's go back on in the storm into Cynthiana. We've got a lot of warnings now for us to cover, a lot of real estate along this. So this continues to look like a big time damaging wind maker that is rolling in to this region. So we'll put the now on this, and we will look at the winds inside this and see what we can find in terms of the rotation. Because I would imagine looking at this, it would be very close to Cynthiana for the possible spin. But what's happening now, this is that backward C a little bit. So it may be just a little deceitful in terms of showing a true couplet here. The northern side of this is generally where you can get that rotation. But boy, northwest of Cynthiana, we're getting in on some decent rotation along 356 and the Highway 27 corridor into Cynthiana, into Harrison County. Find that storm shelter. You should already be there right now. And those winds that are going to come in behind that initial surge are tremendous, 60, 70 miles an hour or plus. Jim? Reports, anything as of right now?
Well, actually, we do have some pictures from the Scott County area so far, and I think we've got those we can show you right here. This is Victoria Estates, I believe, in Scott County, and you can see some branches down there, some tree issues that they ran into with some of those strong storms. Keep in mind that we had about 50, 60 mile per hour winds confirmed go through there. I think that we're going to find that they were even stronger than that, and right. You know that in other parts. And this is where? Derby Estates, and you can see that the tree is actually snapped there. It looks like it's landed on a porch there at Derby Estates. And again, you're talking about winds 50, 60, 70 miles per hour, all driving through there a little while ago within that section of Scott County. And that's what we're looking at here as well, down into southern parts of Kentucky with another thunderstorm producing a possible tornado in that area. And that's the one, Chris, that we're looking at that was absolutely wrapped around. Let's look at another photo, too. This comes, incredible. This comes from the lightning around the Toyota plant, obviously there in Georgetown, and they were seeing the bulk of this from afar because the strongest part of the thunderstorm was passing just barely north of the Toyota plant, but still a very dangerous situation there, Chris.
Yeah, all right, let's get back to I want to get back to this storm, Jim, here that is right on top of the Boyle County area. If you're watching us now from Parksville to Junction City into southern Boyle County, hit the basement, hit the storm shelters now. This is a nice signature on a radar for a possible tornado that we're seeing. Here we go with that couplet, the spin, the red going away from the radar, the green going toward the radar. You've got that spin that is heading toward the northeast. So basically it's moving out of far northern Casey County, right on top of 37 that will run into Junction City, and then folks to the south of that into the Houstonville area, just to our north toward the Milledgeville part of Lincoln County. Stanford, we're not included in this yet, but I'm looking at this right now, and I'm betting that we're going to see this tornado warning expanded a little farther to the northeast very, very soon. That may include a greater part of Boyle County. I would imagine that may include northern parts of Lincoln County and then points northeast from there. So we'll broaden this view out just a little bit, but that's a good rotation that we're seeing within this storm south of Parksville near Junction City that may eventually impact Stanford, Lancaster, Danville, and parts of Garrett County over the next half hour to 45 minutes. It's embedded within a line of thunderstorms. Something else getting my attention, look at this. That's likely producing some major straight line wind damage, by the way. When I see a radar go from basically zero to 60, just like that with that sharp edge, likely some big time winds heading toward Liberty into Casey County, Columbia, Dare County. But the greatest concern, there's a new tornado warning, Jim. It just popped in out ahead of this particular storm. So as expected, that new tornado warning has been expanded into the Danville area, it looks like. Yes, Danville, you are now included in a tornado warning for downtown Danville. And that is, we can plot the information with this to show you that that tornado warning goes until 7:45. Does not include Stanford, Lincoln County. It includes Boyle and Lincoln until 7:45, but Danville is included in this. And it looks like Perryville, is the worst is just to our south and southeast. So Danville, this tornado sirens, if they aren't going off already, they're getting ready to. And here's what you need to do, Danville. You need to find that storm shelter now, because the rotation coming from this part of the storm, from Wilsonville to Junction City into the northern part of Casey County and far northern parts of the Lincoln County area, is strong, and it may be producing a tornado. No confirmation as of yet. So Danville, down toward Alum Springs, Wilsonville, Davis Hill, along 37. If you live along 127 here, find that storm shelter immediately. 150 coming out of Danville. You're under the gun for the possibility of some damaging winds and that possible tornado. Still watching the other possible tornado that is on top of Cynthiana. And put the velocities on this. Let's see, severe thunderstorm warning has now been expanded a little farther to the east. But I'm looking at this area between Barry and Cynthiana. And I bet we're going to see a little rotation in there. And there you go. And that would be the area to watch for here. Folks living along 27 or 36 that connect the rural part of Harrison County in the north into downtown Cynthiana, that would be the area to watch for a possible tornado. No confirmation on any of these, but we are getting enough of a radar signature, and that's what we're looking at here. We're looking at winds going toward the radar, one direction, going away from the radar. Boom, you've got that spin that is showing up right on top of Harrison County between Cynthiana and Barry. Folks along 27 should be in their storm shelters immediately. Mount Olivet, Robertson County, and down into the far northern parts of Bourbon County, you're included in that particular tornado warning, but that does not include downtown Paris. But Jim, that continues to be a healthy signature that we're seeing.
Yeah, and now we are getting some reports from emergency management in that area that over in Scott County, even earlier, a funnel was spotted on Champion Road.
Okay.
Headed toward northeast toward Harrison County. Well, now that was obviously a little while ago, because if there's a tornado now, it's going to be right here in this fold that we are currently tracking. So that, at least that would be where the main action would be.
Yeah.
I'm not saying we couldn't spin up another, but that would be the main attraction with that particular thunderstorm. So we did have that report. And I believe, Hattie, we had some more issues over there. Another report as well from parts of Scott County. That was also a funnel cloud reported by emergency management near, where was that near, do you remember? The generally the same area, I believe.
Okay.
So that's what we're getting from the folks up there.
So funnel cloud reports out of Scott County from this same storm that has prompted the tornado warning now for Harrison County and far northern parts of Bourbon County. So reports of funnel clouds. Funnel cloud is not a tornado. It is a spin coming from the cloud that if it touches the ground, it then becomes a tornado. Hey, Lexington, here comes the heavy rain, the severe thunderstorm winds that may top out 60 miles an hour plus and some large hail. Jim, I want to go back into the southern Kentucky for that tornado warning that is out there for Boyle County, too. As we're trying, again, we've got two tornado warnings that are miles and miles apart, but the strongest part of this storm is Danville down to Junction City. And we're still seeing that rotation that is in there, and it's right on top of Junction City. So Junction City into Danville, storm sirens are bound to be going off right now. You're likely, a lot of folks are scared right now. Here's what to do. Just keep your head, get into a basement, get into your storm shelter. If you're on the lowest floor, put as many walls between you and the outside as you can. No confirmation on a tornado with this. Just take these precautions and we're going to be all right. All right. So we're watching this storm coming across southern parts of Boyle County from Danville to Junction City. No confirmed tornado with this, but we have a ton of rotation with this in the storm. But because the storm is rotating, doesn't mean it is actually producing a tornado. We're looking inside the storm. In order, obviously, for us to really get a good idea on whether or not there is a tornado, in many cases, it has to be spotted, basically in all cases, actually, or the damage to show up after that. So here's where we're getting that rotation, where the red, and there's the new scan that just comes in. Boy, you look at that. That's some very intense winds going toward the west here north of Junction City. So think of this. The winds are doing this. They're coming around and then back in. Winds going one direction, winds going the opposite direction. So it is right there on top of Junction City and 127 where we are getting that spin and a possible tornado. Jim, any reports? I know we had the funnel cloud reports coming out of Cynthiana or the Cynthiana storm. Any reports on this particular storm coming in right now?
I'm getting radio silence from that area right now. I haven't seen anything on social media for that. And I haven't seen anything from the National Weather Service inside the chat. So nothing as of this particular moment in time. All of it is with the more of the in a more populated area where we've got more people concentrated.
And again, that is moving into a much more populated area of Boyle County from Danville down toward Junction City. So we may begin to see some reports filtering on in. It's hugging the Lincoln and Boyle County line. And that new tornado warning that is out for Danville does go until 7:45, I believe. So they're basically issuing these tornado warnings in 15-minute increments, which, because these storms are moving so very quickly, in a lot of cases, it only takes that 15-minute lead time to get these storms warned in advance. And then you see how it looks in a few minutes after that. You can extend that warning a little deeper, too. But a lot of lightning with that. I guarantee you we're getting in some massive hail from that storm south of the Danville area. And that extends. This whole line, by the way, will likely produce severe weather. That's almost a given with this line. Question becomes, what part of the line produces the worst severe weather? And do we actually get a tornado? So that tornado warning continues here into Harrison County and a small part of northern parts of Bourbon County. And that warning will go for a few more minutes. So let's look inside this storm. Looks like the lightning is now focusing south of Cynthiana. So we may be choking off the northern part of this storm just a little bit. Rotation's a little more broad right now. But Jim, what we're looking at here is that backward C that is showing up again. So that tells us the winds are rushing through here. So you get to the apex of this backward C. It's like a bow. What happens with the bow? Where's all the energy focus? Right at the apex of that, where the arrow would come out of. So that's what we're seeing now in the eastern parts of Harrison County. Folks into northern Nicholas County, Robertson County, Millersburg, there into far northeastern parts of Bourbon County. We're watching this, but the overall tornadic signature with this, not as strong as what we were looking at just a little bit ago. That may have much more of a damaging wind look to it over the next little bit.
Certainly strong,
without question. Severe thunderstorm warnings have been extended now into Carlisle, Nicholas County, and points south from there through the rest of Bourbon County, Harrison County included in that. That'll go until 7:45. What happens now, you're getting into the far eastward extents from the National Weather Service in Jackson. Now you get east of that, you've got Wilmington, Ohio on the north side and Jackson, Kentucky that will take over the warnings once you get east of Winchester there from Montgomery County. You folks will likely be placed under warnings too. Severe thunderstorms rolling into the Bluegrass until 7:45. Fayette, Garrett, Jessamine, Madison, Mercer, and Woodford counties for that line of strong and severe thunderstorms may have winds greater than 60 and 70 miles an hour and some large hail. But this is the storm that continues to be the strongest in terms of rotation that is moving into Danville as we speak. So we'll go back into this and look from Danville to Junction City, and let's see how that rotation is looking as we look at the winds inside the storm. We're in our shelters here into Danville, Boyle County, would guarantee that we are getting in on those tornado sirens that are going off right now. If not, they should be. All right. Danville, Junction City, winds one direction, winds the opposite direction. Worst of this storm is right on 127 right now from Danville down to Junction City. And that'll head over toward the Hedgeville area right on 52 and 150. So you're next up on the list for the worst part of this storm and a radar-indicated tornado. What's a radar-indicated tornado? You're looking at it.
That's it.
Where we're getting the winds going one direction, winds going the opposite direction. That's what we mean by a radar-indicated tornado. Does not mean there is an actual tornado with that. It means the potential is certainly there because we're looking at rotation within that thunderstorm. We're giving the thunderstorm an MRI, and it is telling us, and then we're reading that result, just like you would go to the doctor for an MRI or a scan. That's what we're doing here. We're trying to read the results of those changing scans from the thunderstorms. And you see those winds in opposite directions that are right up against one another. You get a nice little couplet. The tighter or the closer you can get those winds that are going in opposite directions, the better the chance for some spin. So Devil Hills, worst of that is off to our south. But along 52 toward Hedgeville and up into the Hubble area, north of Stanford there, into Lincoln County, getting right toward the Garrett County line, into the storm shelters we go. Jim, I know you said radio silence from this storm a little bit ago.
And
anything at all.
That's the way it still is. I mean, no new information. Now, what's just happened, though, a positive thing has happened, though, on the flip side, northern parts of this line. Here in Bourbon and Harrison County, they're going to expire the tornado warning. Now, the strong wind threat will remain.
Right.
Now, let us not forget that.
Yeah, and, you know, we were looking at that just a moment ago, and we said, yeah, it looks like the tornado threat with that part of the storm in Harrison County was diminishing. And that is the case. So your tornado warning into Harrison County is set to expire shortly. But the severe thunderstorm warnings are going to keep coming at us for the next several hours until we get that line through central and all the way into eastern Kentucky. Now, the farther east it gets may weaken just a little bit. New severe thunderstorm warning in Dare, Casey, Lincoln, and Taylor counties until 8 o'clock this evening. And within that line, you can get little brief spin-ups for a potential tornado. It doesn't mean it will happen, but my sense is with this such a pronounced line that we may actually get some damage that is later confirmed to be at least a small tornado or two out of this. Lexington, west side of town, hey, it's hammer time. East side of town where we are, it's getting ready to be hammer time. Those severe thunderstorm warnings go into Mason County, Lewis County, and I see Fleming County now included in a severe thunderstorm warning. That tornado warning, though, for Garrett County, or for, I should say, Harrison County, northern Bourbon County, is expiring. The tornado threat with that is weakening. New tornado warning just issued on the north side of this storm that is on top of Danville. It is to the north of Lancaster. It does include Garrett County. It includes the Danville area, Bryantsville included in this. We'll take a look at this, particulars with this new tornado warning that goes until 8 o'clock. Boyle, Garrett, a very small part of Jessamine County, and a small part of southeastern Mercer County. That is a new tornado warning that will go until 8 o'clock for this same storm that we have been tracking for a while now. And it has a tremendous amount of spin on that. So Bryantsville, if you're living along 152 out of the Bryantsville area over toward 27 and then back into sections of Mercer County, you need to be in that storm shelter immediately. The rotation with that is still there, may not be as pronounced as what we were seeing earlier, but you can still see it showing up here to the east now of Danville. So Danville, chances are the worst of this storm is now sliding off just to our east. But Garrett County, northern Garrett County, does not include downtown Lancaster, but it includes Bryantsville. It includes 27 coming out of Lancaster and heading toward Nicholasville. We need to be in the storm shelters right now for the possibility of a tornado. This is a radar-indicated tornado. And Jim, I find it fascinating that we continue to get the warning coming from this, but we're not getting very many reports of even severe weather with this, but the rotation is certainly there on radar.
And if it's not a tornado, which I certainly think there's at least been something along those lines somewhere showing up out there, if it's not, we have still seen winds that were significant enough to go through there just from the velocity itself, Chris, suggesting that the winds right around where it's trying to wrap together were coming in anywhere 60 to 70 miles mm-hmm. per hour anyway. So you're right. But again, as I have been scrolling through our social media presence here, not seeing that there's any reports coming out of there. Now, I'm seeing some pictures that are coming in from Garrett County, but, you know, they're just now getting into the fold with all of this, passing off just to the south of there. But nothing coming from the National Weather Service either, or anybody that's actually on the ground getting the ground truth mm-hmm. in these areas, saying that they've spotted one or they've seen any significant damage along the path thus far.
Right, and you can see how Defender says the rotation is right on top of Danville. It tracks it working toward the northeast, Danville, Bryantsville, and in roughly an hour from now, if that storm holds together, it's going to be toward the Winchester area.
Right.
And maybe a little south of that as the overall line progresses a little farther toward the east. But that's what Defender is tracking that as of right now. It's not tracking it with that TVS signature that we were seeing a little bit ago, but it has a mesocyclone, which means, yes, it is seeing rotation within the storm.
Which has been the case for a while now.
Yeah.
I think we've tracked some rotation for at least 30 minutes, maybe even longer than that, with those warnings.
Right, and all clear on that tornado warning for Harrison County and for northern parts of Bourbon County, but severe thunderstorm warnings are out for those particular counties, too. And look at that line that extends all the way to the south. Hey, in south central and southeastern Kentucky, got to watch areas of northern Tennessee for those storms to work into your area ahead of this main line that is out there. So quite the dynamic setup. And Jim, we've set this up for days now. You could see this one coming, several days ago with a spin and the shear in the atmosphere, big bowling ball area of low pressure. And here we are, Mother Nature delivering the goods.
Well, we've been watching, you're right, we've been watching this dramatic change in wind direction with height. We've been watching these northwesterly winds come in contact with true southerly winds.
Yeah.
Now, just think about what I said there, folks. That spin right there by itself, the change in the direction, and they have been significant in speed. And that's why we continue to track that threat out there this evening, because those winds are still hammering down. That's why we were seeing indication there at one point where they were 70 to maybe 80 miles per hour on radar. Just some incredible straight up strong straight line wind speeds that were blasting into parts of Kentucky a little bit earlier. Now they're expiring the tornado warning for Boyle and Lincoln counties as it's cleared out of there.
You can see that is moving out of Boyle County. It is moving toward Bryantsville in the northern parts of Garrett County. Bryantsville, if we are getting a tornado from this storm, it is heading right toward your location now. So you guys need to be in that safe shelter, the basement, wherever it is as your designated storm shelter. That is where you need to be right now with that particular storm bearing down on Bryantsville and getting ready to cross 27. Folks up around Hall, we may be impacted by this. The Faulkner area, a lot of that is just off to our east and southeast. And the worst for Danville is now over, and that storm is working to our east right now.
I'm now starting to see, as reports always do, Chris, you go a little bit further to the west, and we are now seeing that barns were flattened. That was around.
So is that with this particular storm?
That would be this particular batch through that area. This was in Glasgow earlier, so that could time out just about right.
Yeah, what ends up happening in a setup like this, as Jim mentioned, the farther you get removed from a storm going through, then all of a sudden the damage reports start to filter in.
Because people can get back to normal then. Now I am seeing some large trees down in Boyle County. This one just coming in 40 seconds ago. You can see it. We'll try to get that on for you all as well. And I'm just referencing to you. But that now we're starting to see now that the radio silence is gone, friend.
Okay,
I mean, now it's coming together a little bit better in that area with more information trying to slip on into us here at the station because of some of the reports we're now able to see. But again, this is people trying to get back to normal, just out stirring around, maybe trying to clean up at this point.
And the worst of this, I'm gonna plot this for you again because now we've switched it over into a little different look at the velocities, and you can still see that very strong rotation showing up between Marksbury and Bryansville right on 27. So if we are getting a tornado from this storm, it is right on top of the area that you see here. And Bryansville in the shelters immediately. If you're not there already, it may be too late in some cases. Not saying this has that tornado, but as Jim says, now the farther we get to the west and southwest of this storm, all of a sudden now we start to get those storm reports in, a barn flattened, some damage from that. So initially, in a lot of cases, after a severe thunderstorm or tornado moves through, you don't get the reports, and then all of a sudden they just start come flooding in as people kind of get out of their shelters and what have you and look around and maybe reestablish phone or internet connection. But here is that spin that is showing up, Bryansville to Marksbury, right on top of 27. That'll continue to roll its way toward the east and get into maybe southern parts of Jessamine County. Southern parts of Jessamine County, good idea to go ahead and get in that storm shelter. A very small part of that is included in that tornado warning. But from Marksbury to Bryansville and up 27 toward Nicholasville, that would be the prime area right now to get in that storm shelter immediately, because there's a possible tornado. There's enough rotation with this to keep this tornado warning going for, I would imagine, just a little while longer. But Jim, still, that rotation is very strong showing up here from Bryansville down toward the Marksbury area.
And another thing to kind of add into that is that we're talking significant amounts of the strong rotation, which would mean that the winds going in and out are pretty strong by themselves. That's what you mean,
sure,
by when we're talking about significant rotation. So that's why it's a concern. So even if it's not a tornado, the winds are certainly strong enough to cause some other issues. But I would be surprised if we don't get a report or something backs up the information.
Right. When I see, the rotation that I was just looking at on there, boy, that gives you some pause for at least a little bit. I'm going to look at this storm. My goodness. We're looking at a slice of this storm.
This is in 3D.
This is a 3D slice of the storm. You want to talk about giving a storm an MRI. That is it. Look how tall that thing is spiking up into the atmosphere. Better than 40,000 feet. So not only can we do that, we can spin this around and give you that full kind of 4D look to everything. So you can see how it is heading toward the Nicholasville area as we speak. We can look at the backside of that slice, which is just amazing now to have this kind of technology that we can show you. But there's the full-on slice of that. And, Jim, the top of that is spiking close to 50,000 feet up.
Right. Now spin it back around again, and we can see something that's really interesting. You can see how kind of the more northern
yeah.
side of that storm
mm-hmm.
shooting out some strong winds initially, that
yeah.
initial burst that's tied to the backside of the others. So that's pretty impressive, because the lower they are, they're kind of picking up on maybe that wall coming towards
you. And that's what folks are facing with that possible tornado right now that is on top of the Bryansville area. And even with this view, let me step out here so I can get a little illustration. You can see how we've got our little thunderhead that is showing up the anvil of that, and the sweep goes through, it changes a little bit. But also you can look at this and see how there is a little bit of an angle to this storm, where it's why you've got that change of wind speed and shear with height here. So you can see how the top of this, Jim, is now aimed, it's kind of, the top of it is out ahead of the base of the storm. So you've got a change of wind direction, you've got a change of wind speed that's taking the top of that storm and tilting it a little bit, which can in some cases tilt those updrafts and downdrafts enough to where you can get a tornado to fire up. So here's what we're talking about, and you can see that how it's shooting out. Just look at the dark reds here. Notice how it then curls back a little bit. So the top of that thunderstorm is trying to outrun the base of it a little bit. And that's a sign that you're getting a decent change of wind with height there. And that can sometimes lead to those updrafts and downdrafts being tilted just a little bit. And enough to occasionally produce a tornado.
Which is exactly what could be happening there. That's why the warning continues to go along. Now seeing some different reports here. Chris coming in from Harrison County, a report of a roof off of a house.
Spruce Drive.
Spruce Drive and State Highway 365. A report of a roof off of a house there. again,
yeah,
that storm where we had 60, 70 mile per hour winds going through,
sure,
or more, or possibly a tornado earlier, too.
And I'm looking at reports coming out of Henry County of 4 to 5 barns destroyed, roof off of a couple of homes, mobile home was destroyed. And that was the one, Jim, we were looking at earlier that Defender was saying this has rotation with it. It was spinning it up, and it had a TVS signature with it at one point, but no tornado warning was with it at that point.
No tornado warning with. You're right. You're absolutely right. That's that same storm, mm-hmm, that passed through right around that same time that we were talking. Absolutely.
All right. So the main show in town is that tornado warning that is out here, and we got to go up close and personal to find that on top of the Bryantsville area. We can put the particulars up on that too. It gets into a very small part of Jessamine County, and I'm looking at that radar picture still, and boy, there's still some decent rotation showing up with that particular storm. So until 8 o'clock, parts of Garrett and Jessamine County, Boyle County, you have been dropped from that. So all clear in Boyle County. Regardless of whether or not you've had some damage left behind, the worst of that storm is now off to our east and northeast. But that tornado warning going until 8 o'clock, and we'll see if that gets expanded a little deeper into the overnight. Rotation may not be as stout, but it's still there.
It's still there. It's just not as tight as it was just a little while ago or as intense.
And a lot of times in storms like that, they can rotation can pulse up, can tighten up and then spread out just a little bit and then tighten back up.
Right.
But generally what may end up happening in this scenario over the next 15, 20 minutes or so, Jim, we may see that cold air, that cold rush of air from the rain overtake that and just kind of calm it down just a little bit.
And flatten it out,
yeah,
essentially is what it means. It's just kind of flatten everything out. Now, that does not mean it's not going to be a strong thunderstorm. It'll still remain to be that, but it could lose the capability, mm-hmm, to force this element.
Yeah, and the farther east that line of storms get, the less the spin that is showing up in the atmosphere. And you can look at that, and you can see how that line is losing maybe just a little bit of steam compared to what it was looking like
so
a little bit ago.
I think so, absolutely. You can see, you can just tell by the overall, mm-hmm, shape of the line. It's not quite, it's developed, but it's not,
yeah,
what it once was.
And, you know, all along we've targeted I-65 to I-75 for the greatest severe weather threat. So you've got these warnings that have been allowed to expire across the central part of this line. Will it be reissued a little farther to the east? We'll see. But overall, it's a little weakening trend. And I'm going to watch Southern Kentucky, Monticello, Wayne County, over to Whitley City, McCreary County. Jim, take this down into northern Tennessee.
Well,
good storms coming out.
They've just expanded
this,
yeah.
All right, new tornado warning. This includes Madison County. This includes Jessamine County. Does not include Nicholasville. Does not include Richmond. But this is a small part of southern Fayette County as well, on the southwest side of town. Tornado warning goes until 8 p.m. for part of Fayette, Garrett, Jessamine, and Madison counties. And for folks in the booth, if you got some cams on the southwest side of town, let me know, and we'll pull those up. But here is our tornado warning that gets into far southern parts of Fayette County. Does not include Nicholasville. It is from Bryantsville to the north and northeast. It gets to Interstate 75. Just to the north of Richmond. Jim, let's zoom in on what we're seeing with that. And that rotation is still there. This is the pocket of spin that we are tracking right now, northeast of Bryantsville. It's basically over toward the pink area, southern parts of Jessamine County, north of Buckeye, here into sections of Garrett County, and that'll continue to work its way on off to the east and northeast, and eventually this is going to push in to the northwestern part of Madison County. So a tornado warning is out for a small part of Fayette County. It's the southwestern side of town. For northern parts of Madison County, Jessamine County, and parts of Garrett County, with this circulation that we continue to track. Let's lose this circulation, Jim. Let's bounce it out a little bit. Let's go in and get folks ahead of this storm an idea. We'll keep this close view. We'll take it into areas north of Richmond. Let's show where this storm is going here across the northern parts of Madison County. So we'll go toward Interstate 75. We'll zoom in here and get some of those place names on where this gets to. So it gets to right on top of 75. Here's Spears. Here's 169, 1156, and over toward Baldwin western parts of Richmond or western parts of Madison County. Million, we're included in this as well. Let's show you how close Richmond is to this particular tornado warning. Does not include downtown Richmond. It is just off to our south, Richmond Center. Here's the tornado warning. This is going to bypass downtown Richmond and just to the north. Let's get into the south side of Lexington, Jim, and show where this the communities and subdivisions may be included in this particular tornado warning. Right on top of the East Hickman area and literally just a very small chunk of real estate here for Fayette County that is included in that. And that may just get a very small piece of real estate on the southern tip toward the river. Let's take a sky cam out of the Richmond Road area, Eagle Creek. And I see some lights there in the distance. I see lots of heavy rain. This is not included in the tornado warning, but this is part of that same line that is rumbling across the Lexington area now. Notice a lot of folks have been heeding those warnings and they are off the roads right now. Numerous severe thunderstorm warnings are also out for this line of storms, but it continues to be this little kink in the line that has that tornado warning that is out until 8 o'clock for a very small part of Fayette County, southern Fayette County, Jessamine County, to the south of Nicholasville. Nicholasville, we are not included in this tornado warning. Richmond not included in this. Lancaster, it is right on the southern part of Jessamine County, down 39 and to the north of Richmond for this possible tornado. It's radar indicated. Nothing has been confirmed right now, but even without this producing a tornado, you can get winds that can cause some issues that may be greater than 60 or 70 miles an hour. But that tornado warning continues in this area. Jim, what are you hearing or seeing in terms of reports from this particular possible tornado?
And again, you know, it's been for a bit of while there where we were kind of in radio silence for that particular area and nothing new showing up throughout that area so far. What I'm beginning to see, though, Chris, is the areas that were impacted earlier, how much a few hours difference can make.
Yeah.
You go from, as you often say, you go from 0 to 60 to about 2 miles per hour. All of a sudden, that's what I'm beginning to see now. But a lot of these folks were passing through. They have yet to start shooting some of the reports out to us, at least at this point. Some very strong winds, though, also showing up well off to our west.
Yeah. And so right now, the immediate concern, Sufferwell's Pike, the pink area, if you live along Henry Lane, Buckeye Road, the New Road area, River Road, that is where the strongest circulation is currently located. Sugar Pike Creek as well, and toward the Pollard area, and eventually into Hunter's Ferry Road, Taylor Ridge Road. We're basically hugging the river. Valley View, that tornado warning is out for the Valley View area. Right on the southern part of Fayette County near Spears along 169. Let's see what subdivisions this actually gets and what roads into Lexington. Jacks Creek Pike, southern part of Fayette County, Johnson Road along 169. And again, this into extreme southern parts of Fayette County for that tornado warning. This does not include Richmond. It does include northern and northwestern parts of Madison County. And we're imagine getting the first tornado warning to expire into the Bryantsville area of Garrett County right
now. Likely going to drop off here soon. And everything on the backside of this, the watch, the actual tornado watch, starting to drop left and right.
Yeah,
Once this goes through, we're done. Getting word from our news director that people have been evacuated from the EKU Center for the Arts. There's a performance there tonight of Dirty Dancing.
Sure.
So a group of people in what would be a strong facility, but they have been evacuated from that with this storm in the area. Again, the tornadic part of the cell passing just to the north of Richmond, which would pass by the EKU Center.
Right, and what's happening, obviously, the sirens are going off there into Madison County and Richmond, but for downtown Richmond, the tornado warning does not include you. It does not include Nicholasville, but it does include a part of southeastern sections of Jessamine County, northwestern parts of Madison County, and I want to go back in and look at this storm and see what kind of winds we're seeing within that. And boy, that spin is still there, Jim. Look at that.
You're right.
It is still there. Yeah. And it is right on top of the Madison, Jessamine, and Garrett County lines, and that is working its way off to the northeast. You know what? If that holds together, we may see that tornado warning expanded into the southern tip of Fayette County into parts of Clark County. At the rate we're going, I would say that is a possibility right now. And for Lexington, storm sirens are probably going off right now, but it's for the far southern parts of Fayette County.
And it's a sparsely populated area, too.
It is. Right, Jacks Creek there. Pike area, down towards Spears and the Valley View, around the Valley View Ferry, right on the Kentucky River is basically where that tornado warning for Lexington goes. And it includes much more real estate into Madison County and toward southeastern parts of Jessamine County.
Ooh, we just took a hit.
Yeah, we took a nice little lightning shot.
Yeah.
Sirens are going off in Lexington. A UK campus with an alert, but the tornado warning does not include inside Circle 4, does not include inside Man of War. This does include far southern parts of Fayette County. EKU, I noticed with a warning that is out for this particular area too. They're alerting students at EKU. The warning does not include the campus of Eastern Kentucky, does not include the campus of the University of Kentucky right now. But for those particular areas, that tornado warning is kind of sandwiched in between downtown Lexington and downtown Richmond. Till 8 o'clock, Fayette, small part of Fayette, Garrett, Jessamine, and Madison counties. And I would imagine here in just a few minutes, Jim, they're going to have to make a determination on whether or not they're going to continue that tornado warning or just reissue severe thunderstorm warning out ahead of that.
Now, obviously, they've dropped it off for the southernmost flank of that, so that's going to disappear because it's no longer impacting that area. But the rotation, as we were just seeing, is certainly still showing
it
up.
Is.
It was as a blast check just
here
a few minutes ago, and we're going to see
it
again.
Right there. Yep.
And it's still there.
Mm-hmm. You're still getting on that rotation, and that is getting close now to the southern part of Fayette County. So I'm wondering if our SkyCam is actually going to pick up on anything. And I think that SkyCam is aimed toward the western sky.
It is. I can see downtown.
Yeah, we're aimed toward the western sky. And what I'll do is I will move that around right now so we can aim it toward the south, toward Madison County, toward where the storm is coming from.
And you can see just by the view and just how much more ominous it looks in that direction.
You can see how western Fayette County is getting in on a bit of a break. Let's aim this SkyCam toward the southern part of Fayette County where we have that tornado warning. This does not include Hamburg. It does not include Man of War. It does not include New Circle. This is for extreme southern parts of Fayette County with that tornado warning that is out as of right now. So again, that does not include downtown Lexington in terms of the official downtown Lexington area. Does not include downtown Richmond. Worst of the storm is heading toward the Valley View Ferry area of Valley View into southern Fayette County, right at the Valley View Ferry. A lot of folks know where that is, and right on top of the Kentucky River from Pollard toward Spears and down toward Baldwin. And eventually, this may get awfully close to southern parts of the Athens area. And I think Childsburg a little too far north for that. Athens and the south side of the Richmond, the old Richmond Road into Lexington on 25 there. We may see that extend a little farther to the east and northeast. No comment yet from the Weather Service on whether or not that's going to be expanded farther to the east. But here you go with that possible tornado. No confirmation, and this is a radar-indicated tornado with that spin that continues to show up. And we're going to look at that spin one more time, and there it is. Between Million along 169, that goes right on into Spears. And that is getting close to the southern tip of Fayette County right now. Red House there into northern Madison County up around the Ford area. That is not included in this tornado warning. But I'm curious to see if we're going to see that pop in.
And the thing is, looking at that when you brought up the velocity there, you could see how strong that the rotation is still there. Because the wind is still very, very tough within that.
It is. Exactly right. Very, very, very good rotation with that. Let's see if we've got anything coming from them as a scale discussion. Home on...
I don't know where Spruce Drive is. I don't know.
It has a roof.
It could be anywhere.
So what we're doing right now, we're reading storm reports as they come in as well. Severe thunderstorm warning for Clinton County and Southern Kentucky. That is with that storm we were looking at, Jim, coming out of Tennessee.
Oh, that same cell that's trying to jump in over the border.
Let's kind of set the view. There we go. There's that cell that, it made up some real estate quickly, didn't it? It's already into Clinton County. Monticello, that'll head your way. Hey, Williamsburg, down toward Jellicoe Mountain on 75. There's a cross out of Kentucky into Tennessee. It's a potent thunderstorm. Wouldn't be surprised if we weren't getting some hail reports. No active tornado warnings except the one into central Kentucky right now. That includes a small part of Fayette County, southern tip of Fayette County, that is set to expire in 1 minute. 8 o'clock.
And they're not talking. They're not talking about what
so
they're going to do with it.
We haven't seen if they're going to extend that. Get some power lines down, power outages in Adair County from this storm a little bit earlier. So the tornado warning has expired for southern Fayette County and northern parts of Madison County. And it's perplexing to see it expire without an explanation on whether or not we're going to extend that, they were just going to let it ride.
Or they're going to replace it, yeah.
New severe thunderstorm warning, Adair, Casey, Garrett, Lincoln, Russell. That's with the southern extent of this line. But we continue to watch that rotation here that is heading toward Interstate 75 and right on the Fayette and Madison County line. And we're looking at the radar returns here, and that tornado warning should likely have been extended because the circulation is there. Whether or not it gets extended, we are waiting to see. 801, tornado warning expired 1 minute ago, and still no confirmation. But what we're looking at here is we are looking inside this storm, and we're seeing the rotation. Here are the winds that are going one direction, winds going opposite direction. Nice little couplet. When you see that, you've got rotation, and that can spit out a weak tornado. Here is Fayette County. Here's Madison County. It's right on top of the river. So we're watching that storm very, very closely right now to see exactly what happens with that.
And the thing is, what I'm looking at here is the level of spin that is left.
A tornado warning was just expanded.
Okay, good.
Tornado warning was just expanded. Now to include Winchester, southern parts of Fayette County, and areas north of the Richmond area. So there it comes. Newly issued tornado warning and it popped into our system, Jim, before it actually popped into chat or anything else.
Oh, okay. I didn't see it over on the other radar product.
All right, here you go. Tornado warning until 8:15. That is now for northern Madison County, Clark County. That includes the city of Winchester, and it includes the southeastern part of Fayette County and a small part of Jessamine County. That is a newly issued tornado warning that is out for those particular areas of Fayette County, included in that new tornado warning. Let's get you in on the areas that are included in this. We know it is the northern part of Madison County. We were tracking this. The worst of the storm and the possible tornado will be crossing Interstate 75 here very shortly. To our producer and director, if we've got a traffic cam out of southern Fayette County near the Athens area or along Interstate 75, let me know, and we will pull that up. This includes, let's get some of the subdivisions in Lexington. It gets to Athens. Athens is included in this. Does not get into the Childsburg Road area. It does not get into Andover, does not get into Polo Club. That tornado warning is just to the east of a lot of the subdivisions there from Childsburg down into the Polo Club Boulevard. Let me take the radar if you'll show you where that warning is. So there you go. There's your tornado warning. That includes the Winchester area. That includes areas of southeastern Fayette County, northern parts of Jessamine, or southeastern Jessamine County, northern parts of Madison County. Red House, we are included in this. The Doylesville area, it's right on top of us. If you're watching us from Forest Grove, right on 1923 near the Lindell area, Becknerville here into Clark County, Winchester, we're on the far northeastward extent of this tornado warning. So the tornado sirens are going to be sounding here very, very shortly into Winchester. So you need to seek that safe shelter immediately with this possible tornado that is working its way through. We're going to look at the winds again with this. And there you go with where we're seeing the strongest rotation. It is on right on top of the Kentucky River, basically, and crossing over Interstate 75. When we start to see the rotation with that, the green up against those bright reds and pinks, that's where you've got the strongest rotation. That is ready to cross over southern parts of Fayette County, crossing northern parts of Madison County, and heading into Clark County. So southwestern Clark County and eventually into Winchester. We need to be in our storm shelters immediately for this possible tornado that is coming your way. That is where we're seeing the strongest rotation that is currently showing up. I want to switch sites here to see what we've got in terms of the velocity here. And we're gonna switch this around and see if we can pick up a little better look at this on a Jackson radar. So what'll happen with this is that you'll get the colors to change a little bit, because we're getting in there. We go there. It's a pretty good rotation.
But
so you notice colors are flipping a little bit because we just changed the area of where we're getting in on the data from. So what I'll show you here is the fact that now you've got the red winds are going this way, greens winds are coming this way. So if you're looking for a possible tornado, here's Fayette County, here's Richmond, here's Interstate 75, it would be right here. Right on top of the river and heading close to Valley View, will eventually head toward Ford and toward parts of northern Madison County, and that tornado warning going until 8:15. That does include the city of Winchester. Richmond not included in this. Downtown Lexington not included in this. Southeastern parts of Lexington, Fayette County. If you're watching us right now down Old Richmond Road, watching us from the Childsburg area and Athens, not exactly Athens, Childsburg, where the elementary school is, where Hayes Middle School is. This warning is just off to your south and southeast. But there is that strong rotation. Jim, let's go up close on this and pick out exactly the area that is seeing this. And we may be able to track the worst of this storm. So still no cam coming out of southern Fayette County, is that right? Nothing that close. Okay. We can see the rotation right here. We're going to go back and put the velocities on this. So it's right on 25. That's Old Richmond Road. Here's the river, and that circulation center is crossing Interstate 75. Does not mean there is a tornado, but this is going to head toward Locust Grove and eventually Ford, which is on top of right on the river. So the center, if we are getting a tornado with this, it would be in this general vicinity coming across Interstate 75. So if you're in Clark County especially, and far southeastern Fayette County toward the Clark County line, and far northern Madison County. I mean, this is just a small part of Madison County, small part of Fayette County. Majority of this is going to head toward Locust Grove, Flanagan, into the downtown Winchester area coming up over the next 15 minutes. This storm is trucking along. So if there are storm chasers on this, they got their work cut out for them trying to keep up with it. And if we do, heaven forbid, have a tornado with this, that would be crossing Interstate 75 about right now. So we're looking at social media reports. We're looking for anything from the Weather Service, Jim, any confirmation, any kind of reports that are coming in that would suggest some damage from this particular storm as of right now.
Not yet.
Okay.
Not yet from that. Now, what they've done is on the southern side, the other part of it, they've replaced some of
it
with a severe thunderstorm warning. So you see that there goes the extension, too. Mm-hmm. They've got to change that up a little bit there with the actual tornado warning. But now on the southern side, which includes Richmond now, get ready for some pretty strong winds here within the next little bit, 60, 70 miles per hour, easily attainable within that thunderstorm.
And you just look at this. We're just looking at a typical radar with reflectivity here, not looking at winds. Where do you see the brightest colors? Where's the strongest part of this storm? Right where you have that tornado warning. But I'm looking at this too. How about this? That's some damaging winds potentially heading toward Richmond. Yeah, almost a little bow trying to show up there. But here's the big show. Here's the main show. That's why we have the tornado warning that is out for Clark County, a small part of Fayette County, southeastern Fayette County. In about five more minutes, Fayette County, We'll sound the all clear. And this is, again, for far southeastern Fayette County. Closer you live toward Clark, closer you live toward Madison, you are included in that warning until 8:15. Does not include downtown Lexington. This is out more along the Clark County line and down toward the Kentucky River. It does include Winchester. Winchester, tornado sirens are going off. Here's what I want you to do, though. Just keep your head about you. You're going to be okay. We're going to get into a basement. We're going to get into a storm shelter, a predetermined area. You still got about 5-10 minutes before the possible tornado would get to you. So let's go ahead and get to that basement. If we don't have a basement, let's find the lowest level and let's get into an interior room. Put as many walls between where you are and the outside. It's all about layers. You have one layer of protection inside, right in the middle of your home with the walls around you. Maybe you're in a different room, providing two more layers. Then the outside of the home, providing additional layers. Layers between you and the tornado. That would be the walls. Mobile homes, evacuate those immediately. And I don't care where you are. Above everything else, you protect the head. Protect the old noggin. If that includes putting on a bicycle helmet, I want you to do that. If you have an old football helmet, a hard hat, anything. If you don't have one, just assume the position. Remember back in school when we went through the tornado drills? That's what we used to do. We had to cover our heads. So that's what I want you to be doing right now. So let's look at the rotation within this storm. And again, it is moving its way right toward Locust Grove, right up 627. And we'll eventually head into the Hunt area and up toward Winchester. Here is Forest Grove, where we're right on 627. The rotation is still there, maybe just a little broader, but it's also seems to be a little stronger with that with the wind, the inbound wind going toward the particular radar site that we're looking at, and those outbound winds. So as long as we continue to see those bright colors, that couplet, side by side. Ford, this is now crossing the interstate. Fayette County, I feel confident enough to sound the all clear for southeastern Fayette County. This is now working into mainly a very small part of real estate here into northern Madison County. But if you are in Clark County right now, let's find our shelter to be safe. We've had no reports of an actual tornado with this, but that rotation is very long, has a long lifespan. We've tracked this, Jim, for what, an hour and a half now, roughly?
Every bit of it now at this point has been gone.
And that rotation has been with it every step of the way, which is kind of crazy. Within a line like this, for that just to extend northeastward along that line. But if I recall, last night we were showing a couple of future radars, and one of the computer models, the high-resolution models, had what looked like a supercell thunderstorm taking a very similar path to this, which is crazy to see it verifying 24 hours later. But that is indeed what is happening. New scan is in, and we continue to see that rotation is there. It may be a little broader, but right here, Locust Grove, now into Clark County. Fayette County, southeastern part of Fayette County. If you're in your storm shelter, you're listening to us right now, maybe we're okay now. We can come out of that storm shelter for this particular part of the cell. This is crossing into Clark County. Forest Grove, Locust Grove, 418, where 418 and 627 meet. Jim, let's take this in even a little closer here. Let's get some local street names here and some local roads to show where the worst of this particular part of the storm is. Here's the Grimes Mill Road area. I see Anster Grove Road, River City, River Circle, all kinds of small local roads that most people aren't accustomed to seeing. There's the Boonesboro area. It's right on top of Boonesboro, and it's going to head toward Old Stone Church Road and farther northeast from there toward True Lane, Combs Ferry Road, and toward the Waterworks Road as well. So Clark County, you know your area, obviously much better than I do. McClure Road, a lot of homes out here. A lot of homes near McClure. A lot of homes near Old Boonesboro Road. This is heading toward your general vicinity. Now, you're getting in on thunderstorms right now into downtown Winchester. Out toward Colby Road, lots of homes into this particular area. So, you're getting it on storms now, but the possible tornado is right here. It is just off to your southwest, Elkin, Forest Grove, into downtown Winchester, and maybe eventually across Interstate 65, where 65 and the Mountain Parkway meet up there to the east of Winchester. We've got pictures coming in. Let's take a look at this from the clouds there into Winchester. And what we're looking at there would likely be that thunderstorm that is on top of Winchester now moving in, and what looks to be a little scud cloud. Those are often mistaken for funnel clouds because they kind of have the same appearance. They're just not spinning. They're not producing any swirl or circulation, so you're not getting wind damage. Now that, again, does not include where the storm is coming from as of right now. Jim, what's the latest coming from our Twitter feeds and the weather service?
Okay, now, a non-trained person may or may not have spotted a funnel cloud along Lexington Road in Whitehall Manor a little while ago. That's something that they're going to investigate a little further, see if they can find some more information. Now we're also seeing that from the earlier storms, or from just a little while ago, talking about shingles blown off of a home here in Lexington.
Okay.
And that's in southern portions of Fayette County, which could certainly happen with the winds that we had blowing through there with some one-inch tree limbs snapped.
Yeah.
So just to give yourself a visualization, an inch
well,
in
look
diameter.
Look at what Defender's doing. Let me bounce this out a little bit. It's picking up on two circulation, so we're plotting this now as a TVS, or tornado vortex signature. That's what we're looking at. The yellow indicates moderate confidence by our radar system. And the track on that, 1 hour, and look how far to the northeast that tracks this in an hour. Through Mount Sterling, through Bath County, and toward the Salt Lake area, almost to Rowan County and Fleming County. But radar is now picking up, seeing enough to say, hey, you know what? We may have a little weak tornado with this.
And
tornado warning,
extended,
Clark and Madison counties. So there you go. That has now been extended farther to the east and northeast. So that is a new tornado warning that has been expanded, and that is what we're looking at here. I want to put a track on this, Jim, and let's see what. Let's click inside this and see what it gives us in terms of what it is seeing right now. Tornadic storm, Winchester, 831. That's coming up in less than 15 minutes, maybe there a little quicker than that. You notice it takes it toward Camargo. That's over into Montgomery County, Sharpsburg, Bath County, 1 hour from now. And in that cone, a little more than 27,000 people impacted by that. And I think that's probably lowballing it.
And we're also getting to where, into a point to kind of where the northern part of the line has already passed through some of these areas, so it's redirecting.
Yeah.
So that would be why you're getting.
And
more
you notice
of that
now what
drop.
Happened with this tornado warning? It goes a little deeper into the evening until 8:45 for Clark and Madison County. So that new tornado warning going until 8:45 Clark and Madison County. So that's a 30-minute now leeway into this as opposed to 15 minutes. So basically, a weather service says, you know what, this thing keeps showing spin. We're going to, instead of 15-minute increments, let's time them out a little deeper now instead of issuing one every 15 minutes.
And they should, because this has had a long history of keeping that rotation alive and well as it's progressed from southern parts of Kentucky to where it is now.
Right. And Winchester, it is right on top of you from Locust Grove and into downtown Winchester, Red House. Worst's boy is awfully close to us. It is just off to our north and northwest. But that new tornado warning does get into the northern part of Richmond. Gets into, basically splits the city of Richmond. North side of town included in the tornado warning. South side of town is not. That Madison Central High School is included in the tornado warning. EKU's campus is not. That is the fine line we are walking with this particular storm. Continued strong circulation with this storm on top of the region right now. And it's a possible tornado.
Possible tornado, which is what we've been tracking this whole time for a while now. So maybe 70-mile-per-hour winds associated with it outside of any of the rotation.
Yeah.
So that's something to watch out for as well. That's something we often forget when we focus in on the tornado, but there's still very strong winds with it.
Yeah, and we're kind of giving this storm a little bit of a slice here to see how tall it's reaching up to 35,000, 40,000 feet up in the atmosphere. But also want to look at the winds again. with this part of the storm to see how that circulation center is looking right now. Let me straighten this radar view up so we give folks a little better bearings about themselves. There we go. And we're going to zoom in here, and there may be a couple of centers of circulation with this. Let's see what we can find, Jim. Let's go in with this. We're going to look at the winds. Boy, that wow. First center of circulation is right on top of Winchester. There's another small little circulation north of Richmond. What we're looking at, and then we'll zoom in here. Let me give people. There may be one little circulation here north of Richmond, but the big one is right here, right on top of Winchester into Clark County. That continues to show up very, very well, and that is heading into downtown Winchester right now. Does not mean we have a tornado with this, but it does mean we have circulation within this storm, Winchester, that it can spit out a weak tornado right now with those winds going in opposite directions.
Now, that kind of backs up a report I'm getting from emergency management now, Chris. A funnel cloud spotted about 4 minutes ago near 75 and 627. If you look there, that right would here. Be where it was just a few minutes ago.
That's exactly right, which is where we said that storm was coming across 627 and 75. And now it is up into Winchester. Let's zoom in on this, Jim, and let's go street level for the folks here into Winchester, because you are likely getting in on some just awful, awful conditions right now and a possible tornado. So here's Winchester. Here's 627 that turns into 1923, the Becknerville area now. And that center of circulation is right here, downtown Winchester and back toward the southwest near 1958 and downtown Winchester. This is taking aim at us. Let's go in a little closer, Jim. Let's hit all the streets here that are right into the Lindell area and toward downtown sections of Winchester. So you've got the Clubhouse Drive, not too far away from our golf course. You've got Muddy Creek Drive. Here's downtown Winchester, Hampton Manor, Colby Road. Here's an area where a lot of people live on Colby. And boy, that storm is right on top of you now. So if we're getting a tornado, you know what? If this is producing a funnel cloud or a tornado, it is taking aim on downtown Winchester right now. That is if we've had a report of a funnel cloud with the same storm that was crossing Interstate 75 in northern Madison County near the Madison Fayette County line near the Kentucky Road a little earlier. Here is Redbud Lane, Belmont Avenue. Here's South Main Street. So we need to be in those storm shelters ASAP. Should have already been there. Mockingbird Valley Road, I should say. And then 627, right on into downtown Winchester. Following that, and folks living along Colby Road, storm shelters. You got a lot of scared kids right now, I would imagine. Kids, just hang in there. We're going to be okay. We're going to hit that storm shelter right now until this passes. No reports of a confirmed tornado with this, but again, the rotation is certainly there. And with that next scan, that may put it right on top of Interstate 64, Jim. So downtown Winchester getting the worst of it now. But if you live over toward where Interstate 64 and the Mountain Parkway come together, that is the next area we're going to watch. And eventually, that may get into the northeastern part of Clark County. And if it holds together, it keeps that circulation. And at this point, it's an hour and a half of it. It would impact northern parts of Montgomery County and areas of southern Bourbon County. But yeah, there you go. That circulation has now shifted a little farther to the northeast of Winchester. So the worst of the weather is right on top of Winchester now, heading toward northeastern parts of Clark County. Mount Sterling, we're going to watch this very carefully. Paris, I think the worst of this will extend just to our south, but there's that circulation center that is now shifting along right on top of Interstate 64. It is hugging 60 here, that basically parallels 64, and heading into the northeastern part of Clark County. Folks around the Klondike area and section of the Shoalsville area, right where the Mountain Parkway meets 64. That is right here, and that is where the center of circulation with a possible tornado is showing up. And Jim, any other reports outside of that funnel cloud possibly sighted on Interstate 75 with this same cell a little bit ago?
At this point, what's happened, Chris, is these storms are traveling so fast that they are going faster than what people can report the information. That's how quickly they've been, it looks like, all evening long, because they are rolling along at anywhere between 50 and 60 miles per hour. It's easy to take a picture, but we don't encourage you to do it if it's going to put your life in danger. But that's what's happening, and they're starting to trickle in as far as what I'm seeing now on the social media feed, on Twitter, on Facebook. Things are coming together a little bit more behind it.
Yeah.
Again, as they're kind of lagging behind with this. But if you notice with this, the circulation, yes, it's there, but it's not as intense as it was just a little
bit
ago.
It is not. That's right. But this had that history of tightening up a little bit, kind of like a ballerina or an ice skater.
Yeah.
It's circulation, all right? They go through a tight spin, and they're going faster. And all of a sudden, they broaden out a little bit to go slower. It's the same concept with the winds in the atmosphere. Broader that circulation, chances are it's not as strong. Now, the tighter that circulation gets, the faster it can spin. What I want to do, Jim, is take that off, and let's put our storm track on and see what it is plotting it at now, and then the path on that, which, by the way, takes it over toward eventually Grassy Lake. Now, that warning, by the way, does not extend into Montgomery County. But we look at this, and what we're looking at here, if you take just one side on that, and you'll see a couple of those that will likely disappear. So Jackson may be a better view since we're getting closer to that. Let's see what happens with that. And we'll see a couple of those TVS signatures disappear. But this is heading toward the east and northeast, and if it holds it, current strength, holds that current path, well, you can see Mount Sterling in that. Sharpsburg, maybe up into the Owingsville area as well. But it is pretty amazing to see that the radar has been plotting this. Defender, very sophisticated radar system, continues to plot that from southwest to northeast. And that is a major storm system that we're dealing with the potential of putting down a tornado. Now, at some point, that circulation has got to go away. That cooler air from the rain-cooled air, you would think would overcome that so far. But that has not been the case. We've tracked that circulation now for an hour and a half or so. And that is right on top of the Winchester area now, and then on farther to the northeast. So folks across northern parts of Montgomery County, no tornado warning is out for you right now, but we're going to continue to watch that. Clark County, we're under that tornado warning. That'll go until 8:45. I doubt that it will see that expiration time just based on how fast that storm is moving, Jim.
Oh, absolutely. It just depends on whether they extend or what happens. They'll never see the end of it. You're absolutely right. Whether we see it race on into Montgomery County or whatever may happen with the actual warning itself. Because now what's happening is it's catching up to areas that have already been worked over quite a bit. And that's what we want. We want it to pass through that type of air, which could help try to bring the level of severity down soon. That's what one would hope for. Now, we're not saying that would be the case, that it likely runs into that and does that. It could very well keep trucking. But even if you look at some of the lightning, just some of the overall intensity, it's gone down. Mm-hmm. Some, not a lot, but we've watched it come down a little bit compared to where it was just a little bit ago.
Yeah, that circulation, not as strong as what we were seeing a little bit ago, but it is still there.
Right.
And it is surging toward the northeast, so that would clip areas north of Mount Sterling, would be right on top of the Bourbon, Clark, and Montgomery County line just over the next little bit. So folks around Judy, Grassy Lick, Sideview, along 460 there into the North Middletown area of Bourbon County, where 460 and 57 meet, it may be a good idea just to hit the storm shelter or the basement to be on the safe side. No warning is out again for those areas, but we are watching the progress of that. The circulation center is not as strong, and that is just to the south of these particular areas that we're looking at. There's the center. There's the